doesn't get anybody anywhere. And as an autistic person, how many times have you been on?
All right, so let's talk about being autistic and feeling like you're never going to get the credit that you deserve. So for a lot of neurodivergent people, growing up, it's difficult because you realize that you might not fit in and you don't want to take up space in the room because you might be worried about how you're perceived, or there's so many things that are going on. And as you grow older, you realize that there are certain things that you're really good at, things that you are better than everybody else at. But because you're not used to being yourself, right? Because when you have to unmask, you have to find out how to be yourself. So sometimes we're learning how to be ourselves later in life. But as we figure out who we are, it's difficult to speak up for ourselves. It's difficult to set boundaries. And sometimes you might feel like you don't get the credit that you deserve because you haven't been able to do so. But as you unmask, I want you to give yourself permission and this space to say what you're good at and to let people recognize you for those talents, because I think that's very important.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. It's Emily. And we're gonna play with my train and have lots of fun. And please check out my playlist and check out my lives, different conversations, topics, and interviews on my lives and interviews on my playlist. And this is an 18 plus channel, and I do a lot of age aggression, ABDL, little space, DDLG, and mental health, autism, DID, and other things that you'll see in my playlist, and also our altars and system to witchcraft. Yay! Bye. Harmony's gotta go here on that one. Harmony's gonna go for a ride because she can. Yay! No, 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 you gotta go! Oh no. It's not going all the way. Harmony! Come on, Harmony! You can fit through, honey! Harmony's a little chunky, but she can do it.
Welcome to the station! Here comes the train! Chugging there, chugging everywhere! Choo choo! Tug tug! Boo boo!
There, they got that red light, and then there's another red light on the side of the train. I think I'm gonna get another piece out of my box. Oh no. And get rid of that train stopper thingy. Maybe I'll do this one. Alright. We're having a slight delay on the train tracks. There we go. I have this whole box of pieces of the train. I like GoGo VTech train, but I also like, what happened? Harmony fell? I like little people, and I love the little people Barbie house, the little people camper, and I also like Honeybee Acres. They're the cheaper version of Calico Critters. Where did Harmony go? Did you guys see her? Where are you? Ah, Harmony's right there. What happened? Come on, Harmony. You got this, honey. You can do it. I think I need to buy some new AAA batteries, everybody. But yes, Honeybee Acres is from Walmart, and Little Woodsies is from Target. They're both the cheap, generic version of Calico Critters. But I like them. I like the baby animals and stuff. I think it's so much fun. Harmony, you keep falling out. Why? So she's not meant to ride a train. Okay. Maybe she can go that way. Tickets ready. All right, Harmony. I like this noise. All right, we're gonna put this train on next. Oh boy. Harmony, go, go, go. Harmony, go, go, go. I love this. This stuff relaxes me. Chug and Go Railroad. There's that one. And then there's the Go Go VTech train station set. I did a... check out my playlist. I did a ABDL playtime that has a lot of stuff to do with my age regression ABDL and playing on my playlist. I also have another video called Unboxing, which is pretty cool, and I think I do this also. Woo! Look at Harmony go! She's cruising! I love this stuff. It makes me so happy. Yes, I should play with them without the batteries, but it's more fun like watching this because I'm also autistic, and it makes me feel better. So if you like this, you want to see more content with me in the videos, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. And be the best baby you can be. And remember, dreams always come true when you wish upon a star. So having autism is what I deal with every day. And I like routines, and I like colorful stuff, and I love trains. And not because I'm autistic, but because I am autistic. I love dolls, I love toys, stuffed animals. Check out my playlist on my channel. Check out my lives, different conversations and topics. I love watching things make news, interacting. I also like Winnie the Pooh. I love Teletubbies, Winnie the Pooh, Little People playset. I like the Go-Go VTech Mountain Train Treasure Set. I like cars, noisy stuff, soft stuff. I don't like socks. And again, subscribe on my channel. And there's different conversations and topics on my channel. And I do age regression, 18 plus on my channel only. Little space, ABDL room tour. So come subscribe and check out my channel. Lots of fun.
I'm just thinking about how I'm a late diagnosed autistic woman and I'm living in isolation and I have been for over a year and I don't want to be, but I just like don't know how to integrate into society. I really need like another person with me to signal constant safety to me, for me to like go places and not feel like I'm having to panic attack the whole time. Anyway, I was thinking about it and I was thinking about how many other late diagnosed autistic women I know that are living this same exact life as me. We are all living in isolation. Like, that is so fucking sad. Like, we can talk to each other from far away, but, like, we all live alone, and we're all sad and struggling, and it's terrible. It's like a really low quality of life not having other people like in it. Luckily, I have my animals, and getting a dog is probably the only thing that has kept me from being the ultimate level of lonely. Because I am damn near close, my friends.